Ladies and gentlemen of the internet, how are you all doing? I hope you're having a fantastic day. So we're here today with Yagata's Yu-Gi-Oh! The Abridged Series Episode 18. It's been a while since Episode 17. My internet currently is atrociously bad. Atrociously bad. To the point where, you know, these videos, they are not even in HD. They're in 480p. And even then, I'm like, is my internet gonna load it? The reason for that is that, obviously, I changed my internet like a month ago now. It's been a month now. But the thing is, because of COVID, they wouldn't put the lines upstairs. So I basically have Wi-Fi, and the Wi-Fi signal, it just doesn't quite reach to where the router is. So that's why, like, my internet is like up and down, up and down, up and down. But that doesn't matter. We're here today. Hopefully it works. If it doesn't work, I'll just cut it and then I'll be back once it's finished loading the rest. So we'll just see how it goes, ladies and gentlemen. We're here today with Yu-Gi-Oh! The Abridged Series Episode 18, titled Turn Around Bright Eyes. Now, in the last one, we had Joey. We had the moment with Joey. We had the confrontation with Joey. I think the last one was called We Interrupt This Broadcast, where we had a lot of these interrupting broadcasts. Interruptions to the broadcast with the advertisements and the with the advertisements, I guess that's what you can really call it, with these advertisements to different shows, to different in-universe shows. So yeah, that's kind of what we had in the last episode. So let's hop right into episode 18. Turn Around Bright Eyes, Fair Play, Fair Duel. Okay. Let's just hop right in and then see whether, you know, it loads or not. That's kind of the best I can do. So, let's get started. Is that the Super Nintendo theme? Was that the Super Nintendo theme? Or am I getting confused with a game that I played on the Super Nintendo? No, the Super Nintendo didn't have a theme, did it? When you booted it up, it didn't have a theme. Capcom? What game? This feels like a Super Nintendo. It's not a Game Boy. No, it's... That felt like a Super Nintendo jingle. Definitely something I've heard before. What games did I have on the Super Nintendo? Prince of Persia. Goofy, Donald Duck, Star Fox. I think this is a Super Nintendo. I can't. Someone please let me know, because I'm gonna. This is gonna bother me. I'll be honest, this is gonna bother me, because I'm gonna be like, damn it. I know I've heard this before, I just can't place it. I just can't quite place where. So if you can, please let me know. But if the second you tell me, I'm like, oh yeah, of course it was that. But like, as of right now, I just can't think of it, to be completely honest. But hey.
My grandpa's deck has served me well, but if I'm going to beat Pegasus, I'm going to have to remember everything Gramps ever taught me about card games.
Playing card games is just like making love. You usually do it on a table, and you always feel deep shame when it's finished. Also, the older you get, the less fun it is.
So okay.
Always wear a condom when playing card games.
Yeah. I should probably wash my hands before using these.
Yeah, that's good. All right, Rammstein. All right, we're getting some heavy metal. Well, it doesn't really reflect it in the title, but we're getting some heavy German music right now with Rammstein. All right, okay. I've heard a few of his songs, not enough to be like, okay, I can place it, but they did mention his name. So I'm like, yeah, I know who they're referencing. Woohoo!
Of the Duelist Kingdom tournament shall now commence. Will Yugi Moto please enter the duel arena?
I'm bored.
Hush, Tristan. This crappy tournament will be over soon.
Hey, pretty Joey, much. Let's ditch Tristan and Bakura.
Yeah, okay.
I
believe they just ditched us.
Like just that. Say that loud.
You'd have to be a total jerk to walk out on someone when, hey, where are you going?
Too, because you smell. Bye.
And while you can, mortal, soon I will rule the world. And again.
And they wonder why he's evil. And they wonder why he's evil. That's all I'm gonna say.
Then we'll see who smells.
Is that your revenge?
Now, introducing the creator of card games. Ladies and gentlemen, I give to you Mr. Maximilian Pegasus.
Excellent.
Terrible entrance.
Evil plan to steal an object from a small child will be complete.
By you playing card games.
You arranged this whole tournament just to steal my Millennium.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Did you even consider just asking me for it? I mean, do you have any idea how much time and money you've wasted with this whole facade? People have died because you wanted a necklace. Ooh. I killed a gay clown for Ra's sake.
Look, damn. Are you going to play a children's card game with me or not?
Yes.
I suppose I might as well.
This heavy suit of armor is perfect for sneaking around.
Did I hear something just now?
Bro, come on. Come on.
Yeah, that's definitely the sound that wind makes.
My voice gives me super strength, but it also helps that I'm wearing a suit of armor. Hey, it's Mokuba. If I rescue him, then I'll be a hero.
Yeah,
and
you know.
Joey's bootylicious sister will be all over me.
Oh my.
Yes, what is it? There's been a breach. Mokuba Kaiba has escaped. I thought I told you.
That's Joey's voice.
There's been a breach. Mokuba Kaiba has escaped. I thought I told you never to call me at this number.
But I miss you. It feels like we've grown so far apart.
I don't love you anymore.
Why are you so daring, Joey?
Found Mokuba. I think I'll pay him a little visit.
Where
do you think you're going, exactly. Limey boy?
I have to go do British things. Like drink cups of tea and eat bangers and mash. That sort of thing. Because I'm British.
Oh, okay. Look, I think so.
Not quite the same.
Blah, blah, card games, blah.
Blah, 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 attack mode, blah.
Blah, blah,
blah.
Oops.
Blah.
We've got you surrounded. Now give the boy to us.
Over Mokuba's dead body.
Lay one finger on the boy and you mortals will rue the day you were ever born.
Bakura, okay. Don't be a hero. They have invisible guns.
And we're not afraid to use them. Well, I have something far more powerful than invisible guns.
Cat?
There's no such thing. Why don't you see for yourself then? Well, what do you know? He was right.
No, I just look silly.
Bakura, I had no idea you were Spider-Man.
Now follow me. We have to get out of here.
You're not Spider-Man?
No, I'm not.
Yes.
Okay, yes, I'm Spider-Man.
Spider-Man.
Now, will you just follow me?
Hooray! I'm friends with Spider-Man.
Look, man. Alright. Look, man. If I saw anybody, even in this world, if I saw anybody, just be like, okay, card. Oh, this monster suddenly comes out the shadows, I believe that's what it is, like Shadow Creep or whatever it's called, and just binds over and just binds the guards. I would be like, you know what? If you want Mokuba here, take it, but let me go. I would definitely not follow it. Like, I've got principles, I've got morals, but when it comes to like, oh, this creepy dude that clearly is creepy, it's an anime world, but he's clearly creepy. Stay away from him, alright? Stay away from him. Just stay away from him. That's,
introducing the that's fabulous Toon Summon Skull.
I love Toon Worlds.
It's like something out of H.P. Lovecraft. Only
yes.
Gay.
Listen, bud. He's got radioactive blood. Look out. There goes the Spider-Man.
Oh, stop it.
You can't possibly win, Yugi boy. With my Millennium Eye, I can see into the very recesses of your mind, showing me every card in your deck.
He's right. We can't win like this. Our only hope is to switch minds. That way, he won't be able to predict our strategy.
Couldn't I just mind-crush him?
You can't fix all your problems by mind-crushing
him. No, you can't!
Come on. Just one little mind-crush. It'll barely hurt him.
No. Bad Pharaoh. No mind-crush.
You never let me have my way, do you?
And now I'm going to take this duel to the Shadow Realm.
See?
Okay, while Pegasus is doing that, Yugi? Could Yugi? Can Yugi? Could like Yugi should be able to mind crush him. But because of the whole, the Millennium Eye, I'm like, can he? But he did it to Kaiba. I know Kaiba doesn't have a Millennium Eye, but obviously he's got, like, this history, I guess, like, his ancestors' history with, like, the Millennium Items. He did it to Bakura, sort of. That's actually a great question. I don't know, obviously, I don't know the logic behind Mind Crush, besides, you know, showing them your hand. Not the cards, your hands, but, like, showing them your hand. Huh, that's a questions for the philosopher.
This wouldn't be happening if I had just mind crushed him.
Listen, mister, do you need a timeout?
Hand over the boy, Tristan, or I'll swallow your soul.
But why?
Ever since Yugi defeated me in a duel, I've been looking for a new body. One without a soul. Mokubas should do just fine.
But why?
Just because I'm evil.
But why?
You're Spider-Man.
I don't know, I'm just evil. What do you expect?
But why?
Well, I suppose my parents never loved me enough. Aww. They were always dressing me like a girl.
Aww.
Do you know they wanted to call me Florence? Who names a boy Florence? Yeah. Idiots, that's who. And I'll tell you another thing.
Look out, flying Mokuba!
What the deuce?
My voice knows Kung Fu. And now to defeat the
Take
evil
it.
Villain once and for all.
No, just keep
throwing
it.
Throwing him carelessly in a random direction. Go, Millennium Frisbee!
It could have all ended there. It could have all ended there.
I'm bored again.
My nipples are sensing that Yugi is in great peril.
Mine too.
Tristan is a hero.
You'll never guess what I've been doing.
We don't care.
Your mind shuffle strategy won't work against me here, Yugi boy. That weak body of yours can't survive in the Shadow Realm.
Is that
He's
true?
Right. I can feel my life force being drained away. It's like I'm watching an Uwe Boll movie. Spirit, you have to take over for me. I'm too weak.
Oh, come on, you can take him.
No, really, I think I might be dying here.
Don't be such a drama queen.
Spirit. Taya, I love her.
No. Yugi, you can't be dead. If
He's
you
dead.
Were dead, then four kids would have censored it. Yugi.
Good Yugi. Point. Good point. Dead.
Holy crap!
I'm hungry.
I felt a disturbance.
In the force.
As if Yugi cried out in terror and was suddenly silenced.
He needs our help. Remember the friendship pact we made in the first episode?
How could we forget? It took weeks to get that stuff off my head.
Yugi, wherever you are, we believe in you.
Never give up, no matter what happens.
And could you possibly bring me something to eat?
Yes.
Maybe some French fried potatoes.
Poor Pharaoh boy. Without Yugi, your mind is an open book. Now let's see what.
You should have mind cursed him right there and then.
What in the name of Liberace is happening?
Okay.
Stopping me from reading his mind. This is inconceivable. Not
makes
to
no sense.
Extremely cheesy.
Pegasus, you'll never understand the importance of friendship.
As long as Yugi has us, he'll always have the strength to fight.
I'm just here for the food.
And now I summon Little Karibo Imposters.
I will not say a word about that, alright? Whether it's cheesy or not, I will not say a word about that, alright? Not a single word from me will be spoken about that. You know why? Because friendship is the weekly Shonen Jump anime trope. So if I were to criticize friendship, then I would to criticize weekly Shonen Jump, which has brought me so much joy. So I will remain silent.
No, there's so many of them. I can't tell which one is the original.
And that means you'll never be able to watch the abridged series ever again.
No, I can't live without Yu-Gi-Oh! The abridged series.
Damn.
It's so Damn. Important to me.
Damn.
Don't worry, Pegasus. There's always Naruto, the abridged series. But as everyone knows, that's just not quite as good.
Oh, no.
Yu-Gi-Oh!
I didn't know.
I mean, you really...
Back off, he's mine. Yugi, I just have this one thing to say. Did you ever know that you're my hero?
Okay, stop.
Yeah, thanks, Taya. Anyway, we should probably go.
Because you are the wind beneath my wings.
Time to...
Okay, I'm done.
Let's go rescue Grandpa.
All right.
Hey, how the bloody hell did I get up here? And what in the name of buggery happened to my Millennium Ring?
I threw it away because it was evil.
That was a prized family heirloom, you giant wanker.
But it was evil. If Freddy Krueger and Jason Voorhees got married and had a baby, your ring would be the baby.
Freddy would never marry Jason. Besides, Freddy's already married. So his job.
Now that Pegasus is weakened by his duel with Yugi, it'll be the perfect opportunity to steal his Millennium.
Makes no sense!
By the way, if you're wondering how I managed to get my ring back, then I'm just as confused as you are. Watch out, Pegasus. Back.
Logic. Now.
Threaten my people with slavery and death.
This is madness!
Madness. This is Sparta!
I told you we should have used the visible guns, but no, you had to have the invisible guns because they're magical and ooh.
Yeah, way to kick a guy while he's down. Maybe if we had an invisible tank.
Oh, shut up. Just shut up.
Look, man. The duel with Pegasus is over. I know I'm in the minority here. Maybe I am. Maybe I'm not. I'm not actually sure. If I knew someone, right, and they were possessed by a Millennium Ring, granted, sounds very unlikely. sounds very unlikely. But if I knew somebody, right, and they were possessed, I wouldn't get close to them ever again. Like I'd be like, oh yeah, cool, bro. Yeah, I'll meet you next week. Yeah, cool story, bro. And walk away. That's basically me, right? Because Bakura has shown no indications. He's shown no ability not being evil. Every time he's there, every time he has any sort of plot in the story, he has been evil. He has been vicious. He has been wild. So I'd stay away from him. And I just let him do his thing. Oh, you want to take over the world? Alright, cool story. And then he pretends to be Spider-Man as well. You know what? There are many wicked, evil ways out there. There are many ways people have been evil in this world. But the most evil thing is pretending to be Spider-Man, pretending to be a hero, just to crush someone's heart. And in this case, even if it's Tristan, you still crushed his heart. So for that, you're truly evil, Bakura. You're truly, truly evil, Bakura. But, this was Tristan's one and only moment to shine. Truly, Tristan's one and only moment to shine. He said at the beginning of the episode, I want to be a hero. You know what? You were the hero. Saved Mokuba, saved Bakura. And you know what? I never understood that, to be completely honest. I do understand it. Like, the power of friendship, so on and so forth. Yeah, okay, cool. Weekly Shonen Jump, we get it. Power of friendship, determination, so on and so forth. But, like, I never understood how they could just block out the Millennium Eye. I did think as a child, that was, like, quite cheesy. But it doesn't bother me, to be completely honest. It doesn't bother me as much now as it is as a kid, which is kind of funny. Because usually, like, the older you get, the more holes you plot at, the more plot holes you see with the story, but it actually doesn't bother me too much. And I think it's because I'm watching a bridge. I think that's why, because I'm watching a bridge, and obviously they're poking fun at all the holes as well. So I'm like, yeah, let me poke some fun. Let me not take it serious. So I think if I was watching like Yu-Gi-Oh, well, it wouldn't be episode 18, but if I was watching like Yu-Gi-Oh episode, I don't know, 30. Whenever this would have happened, maybe 50, I would be like, man, what's this? Well, because I'm watching you. You know what? That's pretty cool. that's pretty fun. So that's my take on it all, ladies and gentlemen. Let me know what you all think. I'm actually kind of surprised, lucky, I guess, and surprised that like it managed to load it all. That's pretty swell. Besides that, ladies and gentlemen, I will see all of you in the next one. Everyone, until then, have a nice day. Peace out. And as always, bye.